Get you?
No, he didn't get me. Try to.
Is that what you're looking for?
Yep, there's honey right there. Do we want to go a swipe lower or?
You want to go low?
I'll take it out to about right there where you stopped there. Well, you should have brought your jacket. Remember, we do this the hard way. Dang, the hole got smaller.
That's honey.
Yeah.
That whole thing's honey.
Yeah, but we want a bigger hole than that for the board to set on.
Where you want to go, right here?
Well, we know that that's an entrance right over there. Gonna whack these off and try going one more lower.
I could go one more lower that way, I can get out.
Okay. I'll stand back here while you get stung up.
Yeah, I'll see what you can do to me.
That's something. Now they're coming out the side too.
I'm
go down to about right there and call it quits. Up a little bit.
Yeah.
That'll do.
honey.
All right, guys, next day. After Keith came over and whacked on it with a chainsaw, what I've done is closed off these three exits. This is going to be my entrance up through I'll screw that to the tree here. I may just set the nuke box on it and be happy. And then once I set the nuke box on top, I'll put some frames in there with some drawn comb. Try to entice Mama to come up. If I can't get her that way, I'll go rob a frame of brood out of one of my other hives, stick in there, and entice those nurse bees to come up. And then next thing you know, Mama will be up in there laying. Once I get them coming up in there, I'll only have one exit. That exit will be probably this way, since that exit down here is facing that way. And once I get all those bees that are down there closed in so they're not hanging on the outside at night, I'll close that exit off. So the only exit they'll have is up top. They'll have to exit through that nuke box I'll put up there. I'll splice in that video tomorrow. I'm just trying to get this done before dark. All right, so far, guys, you saw us cut the tree, shape it up. Now I've went through and screened off all the extra two entrances we made by cutting a little too close. And the other entrance, I have screwed makeshift bottom board to the top of the tree. And what I'm gonna do is I've got two combs of drawn comb, three frames that need to be drawn. I'm gonna set them on top of here, open this hole up where I've cut out the size of the opening in top of the tree, 3/8. And they're gonna, only entrance and exit is gonna be the same facing as the bottom hole. I'm gonna give them a couple of days to start working and moving up until I see them moving in and out of the top box. I'll close this hole up so they only have one option of coming in up and through this box, hoping to entice the queen up into the five frame deep nuke box I'm getting ready to put on top. And as always, these are feral bees, and I'm here wearing a hat, shorts, and a t-shirt, because the earlier in this video where I'll piece it together, you saw me and Keith over here whacking on this with a chainsaw, and neither one of us ever got stung. So let's go ahead and get this part of it done. See the ladies? All right. Dadgummit. Almost dropped the box. It's kind of hard to film with one hand and work too. I know you're enjoying looking at the side of the box. Once I put some weight on that, that'll even that out. So, let's space our frames so they don't draw no wonky comb. Put our lid on it. I'll go get a brick. Not a brick, a block, to even that out, because when I screwed it down to the, we didn't get the top of the tree exactly even, so when I screwed it down, it pulled one end down further than the other. But putting a block, an 8-inch cinder block on top of that will fix that problem. And then they've got the whole front entrance to work on coming in and out. These are some amazingly gentle bees. I mean, look at them. Amazingly gentle. Sit there and walk on your finger. Amazingly gentle. Like I said, I'm out here in shorts and t-shirt. Hold on. Just poured down rain about 30 minutes ago. People say you can't work bees when it rains. It's not the ideal situation, but I needed to get this done, and I figured while I'm over here grilling some hamburgers for supper, I'd go ahead and just do this. We'll piece the last piece of the video in, hopefully in about a week or two, and hopefully we'll have the queen up in that top box. Then I can just put a queen excluder down, let everything hatch out down the bottom, and then move them to a hive stand somewhere. All right, guys, just a finishing note on this project from the bee tree. Previous video, I put a bottom board down, screwed it to the log, made a 3/8 inch space, put this box on top of it, gave them a frame of brood in the center. They've drawn it out. Now I have four frames of brood. First four, and the back one back here is honey. And there she is. She was on the second frame from the back. She's a honey-butted Italian. Can't say that I'm too happy about that, but very gentle bees. I'm sitting here with nothing on, working them. It's about 100, I think it's about 103 heat index right now. But I'm gonna release her back in here now that I have a queen excluder. Put a queen excluder on, as you can see. That way she can't get back down in here and lay. Once this box is jam-packed and laid, I'll take her and it off, put another one back on it, leave one frame of brood, and let them remake another queen. But right now, we're gonna let Her Majesty go right back down into her hive. And that quick, she's gone. Like I said, she won't be able to get back down into the bottom. But that'll finish up this video. Thanks for watching Woolly Bees. Hit that like button and that subscribe button, and that way you can get a notification if you hit that bell every time I put out one of these videos. Have a great day. I think I'm going to go get in the shower and sit down for the rest of the day. Bye. Well, guys, I just checked the heat index. It's 105 degrees. It is miserable, humid. It's amazing how those combs can stay up there. That wax can just stay up there. But now that we've got the queen up above a queen excluder, like I said earlier, I'm going to let that queen lay that box out. Pull that off, leave a frame of eggs, let them remake another queen. Once all those bees down below hatch out, they'll pull that honey up to the top box when that second box is put up there and the new queen emerges. Then I'll be able to do away with that log. Just wanted to give a shout out to a couple of friends of mine. Toral Booth, which has Just Because YouTube channel. Great guy, got some very interesting videos. He's from Utah. And Jason Bragg with New River Honeybees. The man is a phenomenal whiz when it comes to queen breeding. If you haven't got any of his queens, you need to get on the list next year. January 1st is when he opens his queen sales up. Check out these two guys' channel. Joe May, Little Bits of Honeybees, another great YouTube channel. Very informative. If you like these videos, hit that like and subscribe button. Hit that bell notification. That way you get notified when I put out new videos like this. I think stuff like this is very interesting. These are feral bees caught at least 4 to 5 miles away from any beekeeper. So even though they are Italian, I can't say I'm happy with it. But hey, they're feral bees, and I'm going to just see what happens with them. You guys have a great day, because I have.